This is the CSV file. X column values, Y column values. Please observe, X column values are bigger, Y column values are very small values. So here 1000, 5000, 6000, 10000, 12000. Y values are 0.1, 0.1, 0.2356. Whenever you find the columns with a different range of values, X values in thousands, Y values less than 1. X values are in thousands, Y values are less than 1. Applying any kind of model for these two columns, not a meaningful, you may not be getting accurate suggestion. To get the accurate suggestion, you have to use the scaling. You have to bring to one range of type. Let us see how we can do the scaling. Let's go for M1 file name. For scaling purpose, we have to use sklearn. We need to install sklearn. Let us try to install a new package, sklearn. I showed two ways of installing any of the packages. The best one is a terminal. Open a terminal. In the left bottom, you can see. Use pip command. Install sklearn. Pip install sklearn, press enter. Import pandas to read the CSV file content. From a sklearn pre-processing, import standard scalar. By using standard scalar, we can scale CSV values. Get the data frame from the CSV file by using pandas. Specify CSV file path. I'm specifying absolute path. Data frame is ready. We got the data frame through Pandas. How we can scale it? Create one object to standard scalar. This is the way of creating an object to Python class, standard scalar. Then find out scaled values or scaled data frame. Data frame. Now you can print DF and scaled DF. You can see the difference between DF is the original data. Scaled DF. By using standard scalar, we are scaling the data. Try running this one. You can see the first output and the second output. First output, original values from CSV file. Second output, scaled values. To make the values in the nearest range. Scaled values. This is very much required in most of the data sets. If you find two columns in very even ranges, then we have to do scaling. The scaling can be done through standard scalar, which is from sklearn. Import sklearn. After importing sklearn, specify pre-processing from the scaler. In the pre-processing, get the standard scalar, use it. To use the sklearn, we need to install sklearn. We already installed sklearn. We used pandas to read the data from CSV file. We used sklearn for scaling purpose. Let's move to another. This is another CSV file. New file I am opening. see here, first observe, then you can note down. Company, job and degree. Finally, salary more than 30 lakhs per annum. So with this given input, whether there is a chance of getting more than 30 lakhs per annum or not. That decision, that forecasting, we can see through machine learning models, algorithms. Now, first three columns are alphabet type. Fourth column is numeric. In every machine learning models, values should be in the numerics, but unfortunately, first three columns are alphabet. You cannot supply this data to any of the machine learning models. We have to convert alphabet related columns into numerics. For any machine learning algorithm, expecting values in the numeric. Numeric values only can be applied in the mathematical formulas. We can evaluate some results only through formulas that required a numeric content. But unfortunately, our data set containing three columns alphabets. We cannot supply this CSV file content to any of the machine learning model. We have to convert alphabets into numbers. You can consider these are the labels, alphabets, labels. How to convert label into a numeric? To convert a label into numeric, again we have to use sklearn. Pandas is used for reading CSV file into a data frame variable. Then inside a data frame variable, if you want to change the data, then we will be using sklearn. Here, data should be changed from a label to numeric. Even if salary more than 30 lakhs per annum, you can go for no and yes. No, no, yes, yes, no. Wherever 0 is there can be a no. Wherever 1 is there can be yes. Otherwise, wherever zeros are there you can find a false. Wherever 1 is there, you can find it true. Even entire CSV file can be only labels. All the labels should be converted into numerics. Then only we can send data frame to machine learning models for forecasting purpose. So here three columns only, labels. We will use sklearn to convert these three columns into numerics. Company column, job column, degree column. Please observe, converting labeled columns into numbers. How we can convert labeled columns into numbers? We have to use sklearn. Let us develop a program. go for M2. Always advisable to read the path from the browser address bar. Label encoder. Small change entire DF not able to take here column wise. For one column define one label encounter, label encoder. For one column, one label encoder. Let me run once again. This is the original DF content. From that DF, companies column, these are the values. Job column, these are the values. Degree column, these are the values. No chance of getting error. Please go through once again, everybody. You can also use same label object to convert to company job and degree, but better to go for different objects for different columns. I'm going for label 2, a separate label encoder object for job. Similarly, label 3. It's very simple. First, to define a label encoder object. Label encoder object. Inside that object, there is a function fit transform. Then supply one column from the data frame. one column from the data frame. You can specify a particular column from the data frame by using this particular syntax. For second column, for third column. From the same DF, we are referring three different labeled columns and using three different label encoder objects. We are getting numeric representation for the labels. But still DF remains the same. We are not changing in the DF. We are getting changed values into different variables. All changed values assigned to different variables. We have printed. So instead of this, how to keep in the Excel, that is in the DF. You can go for, I will choose the same column name. Okay. Instead of labeled column, let's go for numeric column. For more meaningful. Even while printing also, you can use numeric. Now, inside a DF, try creating a new column, numeric company is equal to numeric company column. Same way, inside a DF, go for two more columns. Numeric job, numeric degree. Now you can print a DF. You can see the difference between earlier DF and the current DF. Let me run this. Let me remove original columns. DF dot drop off company. You can also supply multiple columns. Job and degree. For a company label column, we are getting a numeric company column by using a label encounter. For a job label column, we are getting a numeric job column by using label encoder. For degree, another label encoder. Then we are adding these three to the data frame. By choosing new column names into the data frame, these are the new columns. Then inside a data frame, I'm removing company column, job and degree column. The result we are assigning back to DF only. See, if you wanted DF originally as it is, then you can go for DF1 is equal to something, DF2 is equal to something. While dropping, it is returning a new data frame. That new data frame we are assigning back to DF. Whenever dropping, it is returning a new data frame. Assign that new data frame to DF1 or DF itself, DF2 or DF itself, I assign to DF. There is a way of dropping multiple columns. While dropping, you need to specify in which axis dropping is happening in the columns. Then finally, DF is printing. Now inside a DF, you will be having only numeric columns, no label columns. This type of DF we will be sending to machine learning model for giving a training. Very simple, two concepts we have went through. One is a scaling, second one label to numeric. Both we are able to do through a scaler. Pandas is mainly for reading and writing CSV file, reading and writing Excel file. Writing operation is very rare, reading operation only. Data we will read and we will give that data to the machine learning model for training purpose. Writing is very simple and very rare. Still, we will see that also.